Hey, it's Fran again. At my bench with viewer mail, I've got a huge backlog of your mail, and for people who've sent in stuff, especially last year, to like before the move, stuff I didn't get to, I will get to it. It's all like lying around here in boxes and stuff. It's in the queue. This one came in just today, and it's just the first one I've opened up, and has a letter. It says, "Hi, Fran. Love your channel." Yeah, it contains a Royal calculator. Since I received it as a birthday gift from my parents in the early 70s, probably December 73. In my electronics class at the time, we were required to put in a C in the corner of our homework and test to indicate that we were using a calculator and not a slide rule. There's hell to pay if you showed an answer with 10 decimal places. Yeah, we were not allowed to use calculators. So when I was in elementary school, even in high school, even in the 80s, we were not allowed to use calculators at all. No calculators in school, period. I'm donating the calculator to the cause. Do what you will. Cheers, Craig Neuswanger, Oakland, California. Thanks, Craig. I do remember the emails that it was an interesting calculator. I've got lots of calculators in the queue. This is a Litton Royal. Litton Royal says it right on the bag. Still got the original vinyl bag. Ooh, it's kind of goozy. Got the back of a calculator here. Equipment. Pen. Right, looking at the back, he's engraved his name on it. Very personalized. Comes from it's a Royal Digital 3, Royal Typewriter Company, Hartford, Connecticut. 7.2 volts, 1.8 watts. Operating instructions. And it's got a pen. A stylus pen. Okay, let's see. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah. Look at that. Ooh, yeah. Look at that calculator. Yep. No buttons. No buttons at all. Wow. This feels really heavy. Has this got a battery in it? Oh God, I hope not. Oh man. Well, oh, yep. DC AC switch, so oh. I have a feeling this has a battery in it. It's got tubes. See tubes in there. Four tubes. So yeah, the no keyboard, use a contact pen to do your arithmetic. And that contact pen that would it's got a little tiny pin in it. See in there? A little pin and a very special contact. Plugs in on the bottom there. Then, but first obstacle of maybe turning this on is I gotta open it up and see if there really is a battery in it. This could be very ugly. Could be ugly and gross. Big bank of rechargeables in there, and they have gone crusty. Crusty, crusty. Not too bad. It hasn't like poured onto the circuit board or anything, so I'm just going to cut the leads to the batteries. And I could just clip the leads coming from the rechargeable pack. It's an eighth inch jack back there. I can just adapt a 7.2 volts right into there. Here's the beauty shot. Got a chip. Yep. It's a 7210. Did anyone recognize that logo? Anyone recognize the logo? Any idea who made it? Definitely gold top. gold on with a ceramic substrate. Yeah, that is the way they did it early on. Yep. Lots of resistors in there. It's obviously some kind of copper alloy coating because they're not tarnished. It's that alloy contact material. There was a foam gasket here, and that foam has turned all gooey like that foam does. But we've got tubes. They look like vacuum fluorescence. I can see two wires in the front there. Yeah, they look like vacuum fluorescent tubes. Yeah, I can see the coating on the plates back there. All right, we've got, looks like a little coil there. Looks like, actually, I can take this apart. Looks like this top board just unplugs. I can see it's like a little it's a header, kind of a header. See the pins going into these little box contacts. I've never seen anything quite like that. Little springy contacts there. Looks like that would be designed to come apart. Oh yeah. All right. Ho-ho. And we're in. Wow. Look at this smorgasbord. Back of the tubes there. We've got some transistors. Transistors are probably for multiplexing, I would think. This top board is, it's chock full of stuff. Yeah, there's a couple coils here. One, two coils. And this would be for stepping up the voltage for the display. Display would have been probably like 24 volts, so you'd have to step that up, and we'd have to have an oscillator in here to chop up the DC voltage so that we could step it up to 24 volts and then rectify it again and smooth it out. So so got very tight little circuit board here. Double-sided, just pretty expensive stuff for 1973-74, double-sided board, but that's very compact. Four transistors there, that'd be for the multiplexing, to turn on and off the grids on each display, so make it easier for the, because the chip obviously doesn't have enough pins to be doing direct drive. It's multiplexing. So you got seven segments. Does it even have a decimal point? Very hard to photograph these tubes. They're so shiny. And the phosphors are glowing out. But there's a decimal point. So we got a decimal point in each one and seven segments. I'm going to try and turn it on, but I'm going to have to disconnect the old rechargeables first. So. Ooh. Probably just strip those and feed DC right in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Power board. Again. Yeah. All right. All that foam stuff just dissolved on everything. I'll have to vacuum that off before I put it back together. But, okay, so got some DC hooked up. I'm going to gradually ramp it up from 5 volts and just bring it up slowly until we get the display on. I'm really not exactly sure. It's not getting anything. Wait, put it on the AC mode. Okay, it's on. Just put the switch to the AC side and it came on. So here we go. There we go. Oh. All right. Get the pen. Oh. Some of the reflection down here. I'm going to stop down the camera a little bit. Here we go. Yeah, we got digits. Clear. It's zero. The clear is up here. Yeah. All right. It's working. All right. I have to stop it down so we can actually see the tubes. They're kind of dim. So using the panel here. Let's see here. Going by the panel. Let's see. It's one. That's a two. One. Two, three, four. That's a zero. Oh, that's a plus. Okay, so I'm doing this upside down and backwards. Clear. Okay. No. Is that? That's seven. Seven. Clear is this. That's clear. Okay. So let's do something simple. Let's see. Nine. 98 times. Oh, there's a decimal point right there. Times six. Yeah. 588.0. All right. Well, let me see if I can get this back together. Let me know it's 9. Let's see, I'm going to run the power supply here. It's 9 volts. Yeah, it's definitely 9 volts. Yeah, like 7.5 is like the minimum. All right, I'm going to put it back together. It's the easiest way to do it. I just vacuumed off all the bits that were loose, and it's just the tape that's left, kind of that adhesive is turned solid. Yep. And yep. To vacuum out the inside of the case here. Yuck. Gross. I'm a big fan of the silicone tape. Don't even use the latex-based stuff anymore. I hate it. I hate that gooey latex electrical tape. Silicone tape just sticks to itself, doesn't stick to anything else. I mean, it's kind of grippy, so you can stretch it and it'll have some like physical grab, but it's just totally insulating, and like I said, it's easy to remove if you want to remove it. Tip with shrink wrap. If you don't want to pull out the heat gun, just use the inside of the soldering iron, like the shelf, so that you don't get solder on it. check the polarity on that. So we're tip positive. All right. Well, light's a little dim, but here we go. The resurrection of the royal. All right. 9 volts. There we go. Easy peasy. All right. So 65.9. Yeah, we got a decimal point there. Divided by. Oh, okay, there's a little negative sign there. Divided by 6 equals, oh, all right. Let's see here, just something I know. 6 divided by 6 equals 1, okay. 69.9 divided by 3 equals, ah, still works. Got the decimal in there and everything. All right. Well, how about that? Thanks, Craig. This has been a blast. Resurrected your calculator. If you want it back in the fixed form, let me know. I'll send it back to you with the new, just have to have a 9-volt DC adapter to use your old Royal. If not, it will go into the calculator museum, which is vastly expanding, and I've got a few on the, pretty close to the bench, ready to come up this week. Some calculator things, but yeah, the Royal. All right. Well, this has been adventurous, as always. Okay, well, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks, too, to everyone down there on the Patreon. For making this one possible. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I wouldn't be able to do it without my patrons down on the Patreon. If you want to help out, just follow the link in the description. Become a patron. I'll thank you personally. I will. All right. Well, that's it for this one. We'll be back here at the bench, probably with another calculator. I've got a lot of them. And, you know. But I definitely don't have any that require a pen. I don't have any keys. Alright, well, thanks a lot. We'll see you here, back at the bench, real soon. At the bed.